100 firefighters are finally winning a fierce battle to control a bushfire near Port Lincoln on Lower Eyre Peninsula, but not before 13 homes and vast hectares of scrub and farmland have been destroyed. Reporter Brett Clappis is at the CFS staging point in Port Lincoln. Brett.
Well, Rebecca, as you can see behind me, a makeshift accommodation block has been established here in Port Lincoln for the dozens of firefighters that have flown in from Adelaide to help out, lend a hand and tackle this blaze, which is still burning out of control, but within containment lines just south of the city. Now, while the immediate threat to lives and property has reduced, certainly in the past 24 hours, this has caused widespread destruction. Exhaustion soon turned to panic as the uncontrolled bushfire refused to abate.
More pressure!
Help came from above, while farmers joined forces with CFS volunteers to battle several flare-ups on properties south of Port Lincoln.
We're quite lucky there'll be no loss of life.
Crews were forced to allow the blaze to burn freely overnight, the firefront engulfing thick, inaccessible scrub. Residents in farming homesteads and shack owners had no choice but to desert their homes.
Most of the people here have lost everything they own, mate. Everything.
The light of day revealing the extent of the damage. 12 cabins in this park alone reduced to ash. Mao Hand lost his home of 20 years. He watched it burn from the safety of the shore.
Everything that I left was all in there, but as you can see, nothing worth salvaging.
A nearby home gutted, several sheds, cars and a camper van also destroyed. Some stayed to defend what appeared a hopeless task. But somehow, surrounded by black, some were spared.
We thought it was gone. When we're down at the sand dunes, we looked up, you could see the flames wrapping around the sand dunes themselves, around both sides of the house.
A cooler change brought early relief, but fanned the front towards the small township of Tulka, rebuilt after being wiped out by fire 11 years ago. The Black Tuesday fires of 2005, also fresh in the minds of locals. This time, many evacuated.
We had our plan in place quite some hours beforehand, so a number of people did leave very early.
So far, 2,000 hectares have been burned, leaving little room for livestock. Or wildlife, locals rescuing dozens of natives, hoping to give them a second chance.
He's looking a bit sore. He's got a burnt bottom foot and a bit of a burnt hand. Well, if rescue get here in time, I think he'll survive.
Now that the fire ground has become more accessible, it has allowed fire investigators to get in there and try and determine a cause. Officially, the line from the CFS is still that it is undetermined. However, locals have told us that one line of inquiry that's being investigated is the possibility of a lightning strike a few days ago, that it's been left to smoulder and has suddenly flared up. There are certainly a lot of people who have been affected by this fire that would like some answers. Rebecca.
I'm sure. Thank you very much, Brett Clappis.